This is my response to chapter two of The Telltale Brain entitled Seeing and Knowing. So something interesting about this chapter is that it uses a lot of optical illusions to talk about how we see things and how our brain processes visual information. And I have a hard time seeing optical illusions, and I don't know why that is. That's just kind of a fun fact about me, is that I have to focus really hard to be able to see them, because otherwise if I just look at things, I don't see it at all. Just a fun fact. But what I really want to talk about in this video is the Capgras syndrome, which is a syndrome where damage to the pathway between the fusiform gyrus and the amygdala has been damaged, in some way, so that people can't process emotion with their visual information. So they'll see a person and they'll know who that person is supposed to be, but they don't think that person who is who they really are, because they can't attach emotion to them. So he describes a man who sees his wife and knows that person is supposed to be his wife, but he can't really be his wife, because then he feels like he should feel something. And I think that that would be really frustrating if you knew you were supposed to feel something for someone and you couldn't. That would be really, really frustrating. I think something else that's interesting is the fact that he tied it in with a court case, that this man had read his book and self-diagnosed himself with this syndrome and was now suing for $1 million. And it seemed like the guy could be legitimate, or he could just have been using it as an excuse to get $1 million. And I think that an important point with neurological syndromes like these is that when you can't necessarily prove them through data like MRIs, then they can really be abused to help people get money in accident cases and lawsuits. And I think that Ramachandran's point about being wary of neurological syndromes is also a good one, because once you read something, it's easy to self-diagnose yourself, but you have to look at the evidence and realize that some of these things might not even be real. It might just be someone seeing what they want to see. So I think that the Capgras syndrome is really cool, and that it's interesting that Ramachandran found that it was really true, even though he didn't think that at first that it could be true. So I hope that never happens to me. And I would really also like to be able to see optical illusions, because apparently they're really cool, but I hardly ever see them. So, thanks.